Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
Thank you. Please be seated, everyone. Thank you. Good morning and welcome to Dalhousie University's summer convocation for our 2020 and 2021 graduating classes from the Faculty of Science. My name is Frank Harvey. It is my distinct honor and privilege to be serving as Dalhousie's Provost and Vice President Academic, and I will be your MC for today. We are all absolutely thrilled to be here celebrating this very special occasion for our amazing students and families who have been waiting for up to 2 years to celebrate in person. We're not celebrating that you had to wait 2 years. We're celebrating that we're here today, acknowledging your achievements. I'd like to now ask Elder Thomas Christmas from the Eskazoni First Nation to deliver the traditional Mi'kmaq welcome.
Could I ask you to rise, please? If I stutter in my English, I ask for forgiveness. It's my second language. I'm not too good with that. Kalugisuk, pivanimk. Ah, tell him kolaluksik. Kolaluksik, djejigluk, nagu. Atandele bon maji. Kaskujnuk. Which is better, I can look. A son of Mokis or Kissiga looks in Ogilo. A born Moks no done, tell little me die. A mujil or no, that be tried moodio. A tilly dar, big mari. Dalmanar, ignimudwig, men near no way. I asked the Creator to help. Help and guide these students. Well, their last day of being students, I guess, some of them. And I ask the Creator to watch over you as you have your stay here in Iqchibuktuk, Halifax. And I ask that He be with you when you drive home and that you be safe at all times. Tell them I'm not here, okay? And I ask the Creator to watch over all of us and to watch over the new students as they take on their new careers. And I welcome you to Mi'kmaq, the ancestral land of the Mi'kmaq. Thank you very much. Amen. Atliach.
Please be seated. Thank you. Thank you very much, Elder Christmas, for that beautiful Mi'kmaq welcome. I would also like to acknowledge that Dalhousie University and our community benefit from and sit on Mi'kmaq, the ancestral and unceded territory of the Mi'kmaq people. We are very grateful for our partnerships and our friendships across Dalhousie's campuses, our faculties, and our administrative units. We are grateful for our community leaders, our elders and residents, our Indigenous Advisory Council. We're grateful for Kathy Martin, our Director of Indigenous Community Engagement, our Indigenous Student Center, Indigenous Research Facilitator in the VP Research Office, Indigenous Health Programs, Inclusive Pathways into the Medical Professions, and so many other important initiatives and partnerships across our campuses, our faculties, and our administrative units. We will continue to work on and build on these critically important relationships because we are all treaty people and we take these words and our commitments to truth and reconciliation very seriously. We would also like to acknowledge the histories, the contributions, and the legacies of the African Nova Scotian people and communities who have been here for over 400 years. We are grateful for our African Nova Scotian Advisory Council, our Director of African Nova Scotian Community Engagement, and our Pathways into our programs on the Truro campus. There are two times on a university campus, on our university campuses, that are particularly significant. The first is at the start of each year when we welcome students, new students to our campus. And the second is at the end when we come together to celebrate the completion of your programs. But as we all know, the COVID pandemic prevented roughly 9,800 students and their families from coming together at the end of your programs to celebrate. That is why this is such a special event, because we now finally have an opportunity to share with your family and friends the many reasons this is such a special day. Completing your degree in either 2020 or 2021, particularly while dealing with a uniquely challenging set of circumstances tied to the pandemic, certainly gives us all many reasons to be incredibly proud of you and your accomplishments. Convocation marks the culmination of years of very, very hard work, and your hard work deserves to be formally acknowledged and formally celebrated. Throughout the completion of your degrees, you've spent hundreds of hours in lectures and labs and tutorials in the library. You've solved thousands of problems, debugged endless lines of code, and mastered many new languages and systems. You've designed and created hundreds of user interfaces and working software systems. You've demoed dozens of personal and team projects. You've built community through student society and campus life. You develop skills and expertise with online and in-person learning, and you've adapted to new challenges as they came your way throughout the pandemic. And you've mastered concepts from the fields as diverse as human-computer interaction and AI. You've taken and studied countless pages of notes from thousands of pages of textbooks, research papers, internet sources. You've demonstrated your knowledge and abilities in a seemingly endless stream of quizzes and midterms and finals. And many of you have completed at least three co-opt terms, and you've made many good friends. But as you completed your degree, you also spent a good part of your time balancing school and work and social lives, dealing with fears and anxieties about your programs and your future, dealing with relationships and social pressures, managing your budget, in many cases, completing your degree while juggling a job, in some cases, more than one, possibly even three to cover tuition. And I'm sure you dealt with personal and emotional crises throughout that period, and losses, perhaps losses tied to the pandemic. Your graduation speaks volumes about your capacity and your willingness to succeed anywhere by applying the life lessons, the skills, the knowledge, the passions, and the life choices you lived while completing your degree at Dow. These are all the reasons we waited to celebrate today. These are all the reasons your family and friends and our entire Dalhousie community are so incredibly proud of you. These are all the reasons you inspire us. So feel free to make some noise. Congratulations. Family and friends, although we would typically encourage you to walk around the auditorium and take as many pictures as you would like, for health and safety reasons, we would ask that you stay in place, stand up, and take as many pictures as you'd like. We have a photographer from Life Touch to take additional close-up photos that we will be sharing. Please share your best celebration photos with us using hashtag DalGrad, and convocation is being webcast as well, so you could certainly share the ceremony with your family and friends. Now, I'd like to take a moment to introduce those individuals who will be participating in the ceremony today. And when I call your name, if you can rise and remain standing if you are able, starting with Elder Thomas Christmas from Eskasoni First Nation, who gave the traditional Mi'kmaq welcome this morning. Scott Bryson, Dalhousie's Chancellor. Dr. Deep Saini, President and Vice Chancellor. Dr. Louise Spiteri, Chair of Dalhousie Senate. Dr. Andrew Rao Chaplin, the Dean of the Faculty of Computer Science. Dr. Marty Leonard, the Dean of the Faculty of Graduate Studies. Catherine Martin, our Director of Indigenous Community Engagement. And Dr. Christian Blouin, the Associate Dean Academic with Computer Science, who carried Dalhousie's Christian carried Dalhousie's New Dawn staff, leading our graduates into the auditorium today. Thank you for that, Christian. Also on the platform party today and in the audience are others who have contributed to the success of the students and to the excellence of their programs. Associate VPs, VPs, associate deans, and I'd like all of, and faculty members, of course, and I'd like you all to stand up as well, please. Your platform party for today. Thank you. Please be seated. If I can ask you to take a moment to turn the sound off on your phones, and please don't worry about turning the sound off of your children. Those noises are beautiful, and we welcome them. So I would now like to invite Dr. Deep Saini, Dalhousie's president, to deliver the president's remarks.
Thank you, Dr. Harvey, and good afternoon to everybody. Graduates, family and friends, distinguished guests, what an honor. What a real honor and an immense pleasure to finally be able to join you here in person for convocation. We waited for this moment for a long time, so like you, I'm letting it sink in. Graduates, today is all about you. So let me thank you for returning to Dalhousie for this very important and special ceremony. We are delighted to see you back. Convocation is normally a celebration of your transition from a student to a graduate. But as you know only too well, the last couple of years didn't quite play out how any of us would have imagined. The class of 2020 and 21 missed out on some of the most important rites of passage that marked the conclusion of your university experience and transition to the life beyond this university experience. What's more, you completed your studies during a period of extraordinary stress and uncertainty. So, more than anything today, we are celebrating your perseverance, your resilience, your grit, your determination, and all that you have achieved despite the incessant challenges that have been thrown at you from the beginning of 2020. So, ladies and gentlemen, in recognition of this awesome group of graduates, let's put our hands together and say congratulations. This is a milestone moment, and a milestone that is very well earned, and might I add, long overdue. It is a source of great pride for both you and your supporters who are present here, and many not even present. You did not have it easy, but I dare to imagine that someday you will look at this moment. You will look back, and you will realize, that is if you don't already do so, that this experience has made you stronger. Perhaps it has made you more resilient, more creative, more innovative, more empathetic, more civic-minded, and more conscious of how the actions of one impact many, and more committed to striving for a better tomorrow. And these are exactly the traits and qualities that the world needs right now. You completed your studies and began your careers during a time of profound change. As you know, over the past couple of years, the phrase, the new normal, has become an increasingly familiar part of our lexicon. But this is really not a new thing. I ask myself all the time, is the new normal such a unique thing that happened only to us, or has it happened before? Well, in my opinion, it is not entirely new as such. For societies to enter a new normal is nothing unique in itself, because human history is replete with major turning points of similar magnitude. On the other hand, however, the uniqueness of this particular new normal for you and the rest of us resides in the confluence of the daunting and often wicked challenges that this new normal coincides with. You know what those challenges are, but just as a reminder, let me list a few. Climate change and its looming impacts. They are with us. The urgency to recognize and address the many historical wrongs that have been done around the world and that must be righted, that is with us. New global health challenges. We've been living through them, and there are more. The need to feed a projected population of 9 billion people on this earth without destroying the planet. And of course, the challenges to democracy, peace, and global order that we witness every day these days. I am beginning to feel sorry now that at a moment's celebration, I'm bringing up all these negative things, and you're probably wondering and saying, what the hell is this guy doing? Well, I have a point to make. So please bear with me just for a moment or two longer. We know that the task in front of you is not an easy one, and it will surely demand a great deal of you. But amidst all these uncertainties and all these challenges, I believe that there are unparalleled opportunities to be seized. In some ways, we may well be at the cusp of the greatest creative destruction that has ever happened in human history. To seize these opportunities, you will have to be willing to take chances, take risks, and be bold. I personally, on many occasions these days, look back at my own life and career, and I realize that some of the biggest breakthroughs that have happened for me, they happened when I was faced with a dilemma. I was standing at the forks and found the courage to pick the riskier and bolder of the options available to me. As I think of this, I am reminded of the words of the Roman philosopher Seneca. And these words were said more than 2 millennia back, but these words are as true today as they were back then. And he said, "It is not because things are difficult that we do not dare. It is because we do not dare that things are difficult." So let me repeat that. It's not because things are difficult that we don't dare. It is because we do not dare that things are difficult. Now, that brings me to you. So guess what? Your generation has demonstrated again and again that you have what it takes to overcome extreme circumstances. When I see what you have overcome over the past 2 years, when I see how you have overcome it and what you have accomplished and what you have become as a result, I feel confident that you are totally up to the task and the world is in very, very competent hands. I'm very confident of that. Also remember that your university education has trained you to ask critical questions. And that's regardless of the field you have trained in. You are trained to ask critical questions and make decisions on the basis of solid evidence, not some unsubstantiated opinion that people may hold without having the right evidence for it. This is a very, very powerful tool in your hands. It is also a great responsibility in a world that is full of people seeking to impose their opinions over the evidence. Exercise this responsibility with great care, but also with confidence and courage as you step into the new world to lead it, which of course you have already started doing. So I am feeling very good today to see you sitting in front of us because I know how you have been trained. Today, we also celebrate your membership in Dalhousie's worldwide community of alumni. This is a distinguished group that has left an indelible mark on societies and countries around the world. I have no doubt also that you will uphold this tradition. And the years to come will see you too achieving great things for yourselves, of course, but more importantly, far more importantly, for this world. The fact that you have returned to Dalhousie for this ceremony shows your love for your alma mater and the pride you feel in your degree. These are facts that we do not take lightly. We are committed to continuing to raise our ambitions for Dalhousie, to make Dalhousie a better place every day, better than it was yesterday. And in doing so, we will be ensuring that the value of your degree keeps on appreciating as the time passes. You, our graduates and our alumni, are the greatest source of joy and pride for us. So on behalf of Dalhousie University, please accept my heartfelt congratulations. Thank you for returning to celebrate with us, and I look forward to seeing you again. Please keep coming back. Thank you.
Thank you very much, President Zaney. As many of you may recall, in 2020, we celebrated the first of four virtual convocations with graduates and their families who tuned in from homes around the world. And as we looked for innovative ways to celebrate our graduates virtually, we benefited from an amazing collaboration between the Big Sing Musical Event Group, the Office of Advancement here at Dal, and representatives of the Fountain School of Performing Arts. Jacqueline Warwick, at the time the director of the Fountain School of Performing Arts, adapted the lyrics of Heave Away, made famous by the Fables, an outstanding band from Newfoundland. In honor of everything that we've been through, everything that you've been through the past few years, and in celebration of your achievement, we'd like to share that video with you again today.
One, two, three. Come get your duds in order, 'cause we're bound to cross the water. Heave away, me jollies, heave away. Come get your duds in order, 'cause we're bound to leave tomorrow. Heave away, me jolly boys, we're all bound away. There's some that's bound for Whitehorse, and there's some bound for St. John's. Heave away, me jollies, heave away. They all set out from Halifax, but we still cheer them on. Heave away, me jolly boys, we're all bound away. They came to learn to study, oh, they came to us at Dal. Heave away, me jollies, heave away. From many different countries, and Dalhousie welcomed all. Heave away, me jolly boys, we're all bound away. 2020 brought a virus, and it pushed us to the ground. Heave away, me jollies, heave away. God's spirit is the stronger one, he'll never keep us down. Heave away, me jolly boys, we're all bound. Heave away, me jollies, heave away.
away. We jolly boys, we're all bound away.
And welcome to Dalhousie's convocation ceremony for the classes of 2020 and 2021. I'm Maria Panopoulos. I graduated from Dal in 1999 with a degree in math and stats, which inevitably led me to my career at CTV Atlantic. Now, math may not seem like a likely path to journalism, but it's where I learned one of my most important lessons. There may only be one right answer in mathematics, but there are a lot of ways to get there. And that brings me to you, my dear grads. You certainly didn't have a conventional university experience, but you ended up exactly where you need to be to make your next big move. So go for it, knowing that you can persevere through anything. Congratulations.
Congratulations, graduates. I'm Devar Sood, President of the Dalhousie Alumni Association and a 2014 mechanical engineering grad. On behalf of the entire alumni community, I am very pleased to offer my congratulations to you and your families. I hope you're able to enjoy this very special moment of crossing the stage, which signifies not only your efforts as students, but also the perseverance you've shown these last couple of years. Once again, many congratulations to you all and a very warm official welcome to the Dalhousie Alumni Network.
Thank you to Maria Panopoulos, co-host and producer of the CTV News at 5, and Dalhousie alumnus Devrash Sood, president of the Dalhousie Alumni Association, for welcoming graduates back to campus. Will graduates please rise? As chair of the Senate of Dalhousie University, I ask you, Mr. Chancellor, to confer degrees upon those students whose names have been approved by Senate.
By virtue of the authority vested in me and in Dalhousie University, I admit to their respective degrees and diplomas with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto those candidates who have fulfilled the requirements of that degree and whose names have been approved by the Senate. Admitto vos ad gradum. Congratulations.
Graduates, please be seated.
I'd now like to call upon Dr. Andrew Rao Chaplin, the Dean of the Faculty of Computer Science, Dr. Marty Leonard, the Dean of the Faculty of Graduate Studies, and Wesley Giffen, an orator from the Fountain School of Performing Arts, to present the candidates who are here today receiving degrees.
Mr. Chancellor, as Dean of the Faculty of Computer Science, I am pleased to be here today to celebrate the accomplishments of candidates who have fulfilled the requirements for diplomas and degrees within the Faculty of Computer Science.
Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Bachelor of Applied Computer Science. Aisha Abuwaji, Bachelor of Applied Computer Science with Distinction. Jewel Abdu. Max Kirkop. Jali Jing, Bachelor of Applied Computer Science, Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction, and a University Medal in Applied Computer Science. Christopher Jersina, Cooperative Program. Julia Kroon, Cooperative Program. Noah Lincourt, Cooperative Program with Distinction. Eric Nguyen. Kelvin Ndrege. David Xavier Ray. Clarice Santos. Ian Sifton, Cooperative Program. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Bachelor of Applied Computer Science. Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Bachelor of Computer Science. Sarah Abarbanel, with distinction. Yusuf Abaza, Cooperative Program. Jingquan Chen, with honors and first class honors. Luis Armando Cordero, with honors. Tianzhou Dai. David Dempsey, Sexton Distinction. Joshua D'Entremont. Elizabeth Hope Eddy, Cooperative Program with Sexton Distinction. Cooper Ross Gagnon, with Honors Cooperative Program and First Class Honors. Aisha Gattuse. Oh, Karan Singh Hill, with honors. Ryan Thomas Glessing, Cooperative Program with Sexton Distinction. Arjav Gupta, with honors and first class honors. Yi Zhao He, with honors with the Cooperative Program and first class honors. Liam Hebert, with honors in the Cooperative Program and first class honors. Kasani Hewa Patirana. Shakir Hussein, Cooperative Program. Mahir Labib Iqbal. Gabriel Itriaga, with the Cooperative Program and Sexton Distinction. Maria Louise Jessen, Cooperative Program with Distinction. Ben Joseph Kelly, Cooperative Program with Sexton Distinction. Anna Khan, Cooperative Program. Yasong Lee, with honors and first class honors. Young Liu. Hao Yan Lu. Patrick Walter Martin, Cooperative Program. Reese McKenzie, Cooperative Education in Computer Science with Sexton Distinction. Sydney D.S. Martin. Howard Alexander Pierce, Cooperative Program. Courtney Alexandra Pick, Cooperative Program with Sexton Distinction. Victor Popola, with honors. Amos Cho, Cooperative Program with Distinction. Asif Rahman. Justine Redondo, Cooperative Program. Janessa Nicole Ridley, Cooperative Program with Sexton Distinction. Ross Jordan Robertson, Cooperative Program. Joshua Swain, Cooperative Program with Sexton Distinction. Zhong Wei Tian. Emma M. Travers, Cooperative Program. Lu Wong, with Distinction. Wang Yingchun, Bachelor of Computer Science. Jesse Wong, Bachelor of Computer Science. Tracy Wong, Bachelor of Computer Science. Alicia Caitlin Wong, Cooperative Program with Sexton Distinction. Zhengfei Shi, with honors and first class honors. Yu Tao Zhe, Cooperative Program with Distinction. EJ Yao, Bachelor of Computer Science. Jia Yu, Bachelor of Computer Science. Jiamin Yu, with honors and first class honors. Yun Jai, Bachelor of Computer Science. Yu Zhang, Bachelor of Computer Science. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Bachelor of Computer Science. Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Bachelor of Science. Sargam Paul, science major in computer science. Amy Elaine Steeles, with double major in computer science and environment, sustainability, and society. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Bachelor of Science.
Mr. Chancellor, I am pleased to be here today to celebrate the accomplishments of candidates who fulfill the requirements for degrees within the Faculty of the Graduate Studies.
Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Master of Applied Computer Science. Siddharth Anikar. Kanjika Arora. Siddhant Ashtosh. Mayank Bagla. Balarama Arjun. Milap Bandari. Henny Andrea Sente Nometre. Asmita Chowdhury. Dhruve Dawali. Pallavi Desai. Vineet Singh. Sahil Frutwala. Aravind Gondrajan. Anindita Gua. Prerna Jain. Varun Chauhan. Malav Jani. Yeah. Natisha Javadi. Hardik Dudeja. Sneh Kalpesh Jogani. Mohit Kacha, Master of Applied Computer Science. Vashali Kambaru Kashitat. Asha Kamesh. Harmanjeet Kaur. Japnur Kaur. Leka Kiriti. Arjun Kolar Hanamopa. Prasant Kumar. Rajesh Arti Gupta. Jemina Lodgat. Varun Mahagalkar. Jigar Maikwana. Akash Maniar. Pratib Kumar Manohoran. Aishwarya Narayanan. Alfred Nketia. Sarmed Noor. Shaitich Baitenkar. Ria Parikh. Bhumi Patil. Deep Patil. Fargun Patil. Hardik Patil. Harsh Patil. Krutarth Patil. Krupa Vijay Kumar Patil. Meet Patil. Nikita Patil. Pujan Hareshbhai Patil. Rutika Patil. Anant Pillai. Lakshmi Panoro. Natik Prajapati. Nikarika Prasad. Dhruv Prohit. Sumit Sai Rajwanda. Abhinaya Raja. Shreyas Narayan Ramanath. Chinnanpreet Shudve. Vivek Sakreya. Yashesh Shurijan Savanai. Adesh Shah. Vivek Shah. Niharika Sehgal. Anisha Shah. Dhruvi Narendra Kumar Shah. Sunet Yogeshbe Shah. Zil Mugeshbe Shah. Prakdish Shankar. Jay Sharma. Nilesh Singh. Ruminder Singh. Suman Singh. Aksha Singh. Anurag Shri Kumar. Aparna Shidhar. Varsha Shidhar. Dharmanbal Suresh Kumar. Shubham Suri. Dhruv Tarpara. Brij Vanya. Maya Varier. Aman Vishnani. Punarva Vyas. Lavanya Neely, Masters of Applied Computer Science. Tianye Wong. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Master of Applied Computer Science. Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Master of Computer Science. Nejla Almuteri. Kartik Bhatia. Neha Chukaipalli. Boma Graham Kallio. Mahir Prashant Kalkunari. Dipankar Mazumdar. Chandrapa Nidrapa. Nuvina Pius. Deepan Shankar Karup Shankar. Fatemeh Rahimi. Deepan Saha. Safroz Sheikh. Rakshet Rupesh Varu. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Master of Computer Science. Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Master of Electronic Commerce. Nashim Taranum Anana. Naza Asad. Aditya Eri. Vijay Kumar Ayena Mahanti. Tahajut Begum. Shreyas Batalasava. Kaustav Vilas Dotra. Varsha Mahesh Hemrajani. Shuchindra Kartik. Shakuntla Katri. Ashik Mahmood. Mohan Raj Manohar. Saurabh Minutra. Talope Olanganju. Aruvashi Patel. Abhijit Singh. Hita Swami. Loki Wong. Yen Xiong. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Master of Electronic Commerce. Mr. Chancellor, the following candidates are here today to receive the Master of Health Informatics. Rahul Gulati. Ulashun Tope Kakabu. Zaina Maria. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of those candidates who are here today to receive the Master of Health Informatics.
Mr. Chancellor, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is the highest earned degree awarded by the university, and as such it represents the culmination of the candidate's educational achievement. The following candidates, through thesis and examination, have fulfilled the requirements for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. And furthermore, Mr. Chancellor, the awarding of the PhD degree completes a long cooperation between the student and their thesis advisor. And we are pleased in this ceremony also to recognize the supervisor of the doctoral candidate. And we ask the supervisor to stand and remain standing as the graduate crosses the stage. And following the awarding of the degree, we would invite you to sit on the stage with the faculty. Congratulations.
Sara Kanchi, Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science with supervisors Dr. Zinkur Haywood and Dr. Malcolm Haywood. Yoshimasa Kubo, Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science with supervisors Thomas Trappenborg and Sapir Orr. Praveen Nadukalam Varindran, Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Science with supervisors Robert Bako and Pan Braidberg. Lema Samir Kushain, Doctor of Philosophy in Interdisciplinary Studies with supervisors Dr. Vivian Howard, Dr. Anthony Gruzard, Dr. Sandra Toes, and Dr. Evangelos Milos. Mr. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the degree of Doctor of Philosophy.
I should point out very briefly that Lama traveled here from Saudi Arabia for this occasion. Thank you. And please, a round of applause for our amazing order from the Fountain School of Performing Arts, Wesley Giffen. Thank you, Wesley. Please join me once again in congratulating all of our graduates and their escorts today. They're amazing. I would now like to call attention to the families and the friends of our graduates. We know that convocation is obviously an important occasion for you. I'm sure all of us can appreciate and certainly recognize the important role that you played in the success of our graduates today. So we would like to express our gratitude to you for the role that you've played. And I'll ask the graduates to please stand up one last time. And if I can ask the onstage party to stand up as well. Graduates, your family and friends have been applauding you throughout the convocation ceremony today. They've made a lot of noise in honor of your achievements. So now it's your turn and our turn to thank them for the role they played in your success. Thank you. Thank you very much. Please be seated. One final congratulations to our 2020 and 2021 graduates. We are thrilled to have you now as part of our Dalhousie alumni family with over 152,000 people from around the world. Graduates and guests, the business of convocation is concluded. After the singing of O Canada, you are requested, if you are able, requested to remain standing as the academic procession leaves the auditorium. We would like to extend our thanks to Elder George Paul for allowing us to play the Mi'kmaq honor song as the graduates leave the ceremony today. And I now invite you to join Samantha Fullerton, a Dalhousie voice student in the Fountain School of Performing Arts, in the singing of our national anthem. Thank you.
Oh, my. Hey, oh.